one's PG-13, FYI, so hopefully that's okay for everybody, and it's 16 minutes, so here I go. Yes, I'm Latane Conant, the CMO of Sixth Sense, and for the last 12 months, I've slept, dreamed, breathed, everything ABM. And after that journey, I'm here today to call BS on the entire thing. But before I do that, what I want to do is I actually want to zoom out for a second, and I want to talk about how our buyers today buy. Buyers today are anonymous. So they're on our website, if we're lucky. They're on our competitor's website. Maria mentioned G2 Crowd. They're there. They're on trade periodicals. And they're anonymous. The second thing about buyers today is they're fragmented. So it's not a lead. It's not a contact. It's 9.6 different people with opinions and objectives and issues involved in every single one of our B2B buying cycles. So they're fragmented. The third thing about B2B buyers is they're resistant. It's going to take us 12, 14, 16, 22 highly personalized, multi-touch, multi-tactic touches to even get a glimmer of hope with a buyer today. So anonymous, fragmented, and resistant. So now I want to compare that to our digital marketing bag of tricks, okay? So what I just explained to you creates what we call at Sixth Sense a dark funnel. So all of the amazing, rich research that's going on with accounts that probably want to buy our stuff right now are happening in this dark funnel, which we have no ability to uncover. But what we do have, wait for it, is a form. So we got the form, and every now and then, somebody comes in. We got Mickey Mouse at AOL.com. Yes! The other thing we have is we've got swag and a lead scanner. So we're giving out our squishy balls and our stuffed animals, and boom! Now we got Mickey Mouse and Sally swag as leads. Awesome. We are so winning. Then we take that and we do a nurture track. Well, I love the name nurture track. I call a nurture track a one-way track to Unsubscribe Island. Because basically we're going to spam the hell out of Mickey Mouse and Sally Swag. And then what we do, this is another one of my favorites, is we come up with a point system, and we maybe even buy software, to deem Sally and Mickey Mouse qualified, pass it to sales, put it on a stuck leads report, and then get super pissed that they haven't followed up. So maybe I'm exaggerating. Maybe I'm not. I actually asked my team to say, how much effort are we wasting on this nonsense? And they came up with a bunch of stats on how much we waste every minute, but the staggering one to me was B2B marketers send 300 billion emails a year. There's only 7 billion people on the planet, folks. And that's not even B2C, so that doesn't even count if you're on Pottery Barn's list, heaven forbid. So this bag of tricks, it's not great. So thank God, ABM comes to the rescue, right? I mean, I needed help. So ABM tells us, be strategic. Be value-add marketing. Align with sales. Okay, thanks. I had never, ever thought of that. So I'm a simplifier. So I think of ABM as five things. One, you got to pick the right accounts. Okay, ideally, you know your ICP. Please say you do. So you pick the right accounts. Second thing about ABM is you kind of got to know something about them. What's their tech stack? Who are those personas? What are they interested in? Third thing, ABM, you need to engage the right way. Okay, so you got those 9.6 people. You got to hit them with different touches. You got to be personalized for the persona, their timing. You got to be able to orchestrate all that in a beautiful campaign. You got to collaborate with sales. They need to know what you're doing. They need to know when to call, why it matters, which personas matter. And last but not least, my favorite, we got to track real stuff, like pipeline, like how our ICP personas are engaging, like how many accounts we're getting in market. So it's not that difficult. And when we do this, oh my God, it's amazing. It's raining goodness. We're best friends with sales. We have bigger deals. We have better conversions. Everything's amazing. But there's one dirty little secret, guys. We can only, it's hard. That's really fucking hard, what I just explained. And so we can only do it for like 10 accounts, maybe 10, maybe 50, maybe 1,000. And so that's the punch in the gut about ABM, is it's literally impossible to execute with any type of scale without AI insights and orchestration. Because yes, we've got great people, we've got great teams, we've got processes, and we got a lot of technology, 7,000 different tools, but we don't have insights and orchestration. So what ends up happening is you take that same flow, and it's fraught with issues. And I only have 16 minutes, so I can't go through. I'm just going to go through one, though. I'm going to go through the top one, which is my favorite, which is select the best accounts. Okay, so should I do it the accounts in my CRM? Only 13% of sellers and marketers have any confidence in their CRM data. Okay, so we can't do that. What about the stuff in our map? Well, that's Sally Swag and Mickey Mouse. Okay, so forget about that. So let's just ask sales. So we just ask sales. What are the best accounts? That is my favorite, because you get what I call the ABM potluck dinner. You get, well, you know what? The Canada GM is really, really into it. Let's do some of his. And we want to do more retail, so put some of them in there. And you have this potluck dinner of accounts that you're supposed to be successful on. So anyway, I'm not going to go through the whole thing. And I'm not here to depress you. Because there is a promised land. And the promised land goes back to the three things I told you about B2B buyers, okay? I told you that they were anonymous. Well, in the promised land, we can uncover all of that anonymous activity. That dark funnel I talked about is illuminated. We know those rich insights. We know they're on our competitor's website and not on our website. We know the keywords they care about. We're able to uncover. The second thing about the promised land is I talked about this buying group and this team, and you can get bounced all around and not know where to focus your valuable time. I don't know about you, my budget's not going up. You have to be able to prioritize accounts that are actually in market, that are showing signs across the buying team of being good opportunities for you and sales to collaborate on. And then the third thing is, you got to be able to orchestrate that amazing engagement, one brain, from direct mail to maybe a little bit of email, I'm not a huge fan, but to content, to display. One brain, personalized, multi-touch. That's the promised land. And when you have this in one platform, not 5,500, it starts to get kind of cool, because here's what happens. You can go back to being a marketer, and you get to define the business objective. You get to create the content and the creative, which I love. I'm an arts and crafts marketer. You set the budget. You define the experience you want your prospects to have. And all of that hard work gets orchestrated for you by the platform. So you probably don't believe me. So I'm going to walk you through an example. I kind of didn't believe it either. But this is a true story, and I have lots of different examples, but this one's kind of fun. So about 3 months ago, the sales team came to me and they said, one of our competitors has bobbled a product release. We have to do a competitive takeout. Latane, we have to do a competitive takeout. It's going to be so awesome. I thought it was a dumb idea. I really didn't want to do it, but sometimes you got to throw sales a bone. So I was like, all right, fine. And I have sixth sense. Fuck it. I should be able to do this. I got it. So I was like, okay, sixth sense. what accounts? And so Sixth Sense said, well, there's 203 accounts that either have this competitive vendor installed or are about to buy this competitive vendor. So those seem like pretty good accounts for a takeout. All right, cool. Now, what else did I tell you? We need to know about them. So Sixth Sense told me the key personas. They told me where they were in their journey. But they also told me the keywords, what keywords that they cared about. Why is that important? Because I'm not coming up with the creative in my ivory tower. I'm looking at those keywords, and I'm coming up with the creative. And Ivan, who's our creative guy, God bless him, keyed in on this Oceanos, which is actually a MarTech vendor. Who knew? And so we created some creative. So are you fishing for whales in your bathtub or open yourself up to oceans of opportunity? All right, cool. Sixth Sense A-B tested those. The whales won, which is pretty fun. And we mixed in a little BDR cadence with ads. So that was the experience we chose. And I set a budget of $400. Away we go. Sales got told when accounts were engaging, when new personas were engaging, and when accounts reached in market, so they should call them and what they should talk to them about. I didn't have to get on a bunch of phone calls. I didn't have to send a bunch of Slacks. This just happened real time. And then last but not least, I got to track real stuff. I got 5 new accounts in market. That's pretty cool. I actually got a new op. That's pretty cool. But that's not what is, I think, like so mind-blowing and amazing about this story. What's amazing to me about this story is it cost me $237, about 6 man hours to complete. And it was just this eye-opening moment for me, like, holy shit. I didn't need a data lake or a pond or a stream or a bunch of AI data scientists. Like, I had all the insights right there. I got to actually put the market in marketing because I reacted to something that was timely and real and relevant. I got to do what I call audience first creative. So again, we didn't have a meeting 9 months earlier and come up with the campaign. We actually looked at the keywords and we queued all of our creative and content based on that. And then I had one brain that executed this. I could have mixed in some other stuff if my budget had allowed. I could have said throw in a field marketing event, some direct mail, but I didn't choose to do that. And I think what's so cool about this is almost infinitely scalable. Like, I'm so fired up that I want to give our BDRs their own budget to say, you know what? Like, you go, you execute. Let's get as close to the prospects and customers as we can. And to me, this isn't ABM or anything special. This is just the future of B2B marketing. And I've never been more excited to be a CMO and in marketing than I am now with the AI insights and orchestration capabilities that we have. So thank you.